Animal laparoscopy is an endoscope used for intraperitoneal examination and treatment of animals. Laparoscopic surgery in animals is now widely used in animal clinics due to its advantages of less trauma, less bleeding, lower risk of infection, and faster recovery. Next, we'll learn to use animal laparoscopy with the example of laparoscopic spaying of female cats. Pre-surgery preparation. Preoperative animal preparation. The surgical object of this operation is a pet cat, female cat, 5 years old, 3.5 kg. Preoperative examination including general examination, blood routine, biochemistry, blood coagulation test, cardiac ultrasound, etc., to minimize the risks associated with pet anesthesia and surgery. Preoperative fasting of 6 hours and 2 hours of water is required to empty the stomach to avoid regurgitation of undigested food in the stomach during anesthesia, leading to blockage of the airway by vomit. Consumables and medications preparation. Consumables such as syringes, surgical sutures, surgical wound towels, drugs such as dexmedetomidine, propofol, saline, iodophor, etc. Surgical equipment included surgical instruments, including pneumoperitoneum needle and puncturer, laparoscope, ultrasonic knife, anesthesia machine, cardiac monitor, etc. All equipment was turned on and debugged to normal. This operation used Juhai TK Vetkit animal laparoscopy system, including camera, laparoscope specification of 5.0 mm outer diameter, 290 working length, image processor, light source, pneumoperitoneum machine. The anesthesiologist injected sedative drugs intravenously and pre-inhaled oxygen for more than 10 minutes. Implement tracheal intubation, receive inhaled anesthetic gas, and the animal enters a stable anesthetic state. Place a mouth plug to prevent the animal from accidentally regaining jaw tension during surgery. The anesthesiologist monitored the vital signs and observed the state of the eyes throughout the surgery, and paid attention to the animal's respiratory rate. The surgical animal was placed in the supine position, the limbs were tied and fixed. The surgical area is disinfected with towels and then wrapped by the assistant with a sterile protective sleeve for the pneumoperitoneal needle guide tube and laparoscopic connection line, and placed in the sterile area after wrapping. Laparoscopic spaying of female cats. Pneumoperitoneum establishment. Laparoscopic sterilization uses the two-hole method to establish the pneumoperitoneum, i.e., two holes are chosen to be made in the midline of the abdomen, and the size of both the anterior umbilical puncture hole and the anterior pubic bone puncture hole is about 5 millimeters. A small incision is made at the navel or the umbilicus, which is the weakest point on the abdominal wall, and a hemostat is used to bluntly separate the subcutaneous tissue, and the abdominal wall tissue is held away from the abdominal cavity with a clamp, and a pneumoperitoneum needle is held in the other hand, and the pneumoperitoneum needle is inserted at a 45 degrees angle caudally. The pneumoperitoneum tube is connected to instill CO2 into the abdominal cavity to inflate the cavity until the intra-abdominal pressure is stabilized at 6 to 12 millimeters of mercury to provide working space and visualization. Place the puncture trocha while removing the pneumoperitoneum needle. Attach the pneumoperitoneum tube to the trocha. Establish the laparoscopic access and reach into the rigid endoscope to explore the abdominal cavity. The picture above shows the method of holding the trocar needle by hand. This method can avoid the damage to the abdominal organs caused by the trocar needle entering too much. Guided by the laparoscope, instrument access is established at the appropriate location, which can effectively avoid damage to the abdominal organs. The surgical animal is slightly off to one side and the ovarian uterus on the opposite side is found to be suspended in situ with sutures to prevent dislocation. The same operation deals with the opposite side. When pulling the uterine ovaries out of the body in a conventional surgical procedure, the animal often has a rapid heart rate due to pulling and stimulating the vagus nerve, which is actually a sign of pain. However, a similar situation does not occur in laparoscopic sterilization. Laparoscopic administration of local anesthesia, lidocaine, reduces postoperative discomfort in animals. Ovarectomy. Using ultrasonic knife or bipolar electrocoagulation for hierarchical dissection, the ovarian artery and vein are first coagulated and then cut, and then the separation continues along the broad ligament of the uterus toward the suspensory ligament of the ovary, and finally the junction of the ovary and uterus is dissected to separate the complete ovary. It can be cut from the middle to the left and right sides. Release the suspensory cord, separate the abdominal wall from the resected ovary, and use foreign body forceps to remove the cut ovarian tissue from the instrument channel. The ovary is too large to be removed from the incision by first withdrawing the perforator cannula. If the ovary is too large to come out, reaming can be performed to remove the ovary from the body. Precautions for laparoscopic poke card withdrawal. Turn off the pneumoperitoneum machine first, and then use the puncturer trocar to slowly vent the air so that the abdominal pneumoperitoneum pressure slowly decreases. Under laparoscopic observation, slowly remove the punctured cannula. Do not withdraw the puncturer trocar suddenly when the intraabdominal pressure is high, which will cause the intraabdominal organs to be stuck on the mouth of the puncturer trocar and cause injury. Wound treatment. To be withdrawn from all equipment and instruments, wound suture treatment was performed, including muscle suture and skin suture, etc. After the suture, a band-aid was applied to the wound. After the operation, only two incisions of about 5 mm in size were left in the abdomen. Postoperative care. After the surgical animal is fully awake, for hours after surgery, it is recommended to give some easily digestible and highly nutritious food, such as prescription canned food or nutritional cream. The animal can be discharged after the spay/neuter surgery. Elizabethan collars need to be worn for 7 days during this period to prevent the postoperative animal from licking the wound and affecting the wound healing. Sterilization of postoperative laparoscopes and instruments. Wash thoroughly with running water immediately after use to remove residual substances such as blood and mucus, and wipe dry. Place the dried endoscope in multi-enzyme washing solution and soak it. Thoroughly clean each part of the endoscope. The tube cavity should be thoroughly rinsed with a high-pressure water gun. The detachable part must be disassembled and cleaned with an ultrasonic cleaner for 5 min 10 min. Thoroughly brush the tube cavity with soft bristle brush, and pay attention to avoid scratching the endoscope's surface when brushing. After chemical disinfection with advanced disinfection solution of 2% glutaraldehyde, adopt ethylene oxide gas sterilization or low-temperature plasma sterilization. Advantages of laparoscopic spaying of female cats. Compared to traditional open sterilization, laparoscopic minimally invasive sterilization has the following advantages. Small incision and fast healing. The surgical incision is extremely small and the animal healing time is accelerated. Less bleeding and less irritation. Ultrasonic knife is used throughout the surgical ligation. Very little or no bleeding at all. No ligature irritation. nose suture allergy, and other problems. Reducing postoperative pain, adequate exposure, easy operation, avoiding organ pulling pain during surgery, and smaller incisions also reduce postoperative pain. Reduction of surgical complications, shorter operation time, less trauma, and significant reduction of postoperative adhesions and other complications. Simple postoperative care, simplifying the care process and shortening the treatment time makes the possibility of infection much less. Other applications of laparoscopy. The application of minimally invasive laparoscopic surgery is not only in animal sterilization, but also in abdominal cavity exploration, examination and sampling of tumors or lesions in various organs of the abdominal cavity and their removal, such as gallbladder removal, bladder stone removal, kidney stone removal, and cryptorchidism surgery. The laparoscope is used to enter the abdominal cavity for exploration and to view the anatomical structure of the abdominal organs and any abnormalities under direct vision.